Good morning to all. Today we discuss about the type of the flip-flop. As we have already discussed two kind of the shift register. Now today we will discuss the parallel into serial out shift register. The parallel into serial out shift register act in the opposite way to the serial into parallel out one above. The data is loaded into the register in a parallel format for in which all the data bits enter their input simultaneously to the parallel input pin PA to PD of the register. The data is then read out sequentially in the normal shift right mode from the register at a queue representing the data present at a PA to PD. This data is outputted one bit at a time on each clock cycle in a serial format. It is important to note that with this type of the data register, a clock pulse is not required to parallel loaded the register as it is already present, but four clock pulses are required to unlock the data. And we can understand this whole process to take an example of 4-bit parallel into serial out shift register. This diagram indicating the this. Since we are using the 4-bit, so we have to use 4 number of the D type of flip-flop, which are indicating flip-flop A, flip-flop B, flip-flop C and flip-flop D. In all these flip-flop, all clock pulses are connected in a parallel manner. That means we apply this clock pulse simultaneously at all D type of flip-flop. And we apply the input all flip-flop in a parallel manner as well as the sequentially which is generated previously output flip-flop. This kind of flip-flop can be used to multiplex many different input lines into a single serial data stream, which can be sent directly to a computer or that transmitted over a communication line. And it is clear from the diagram we using the multiplexer circuit. Next, we discuss about the parallel into parallel out shift register. This is the final mode of operation is the parallel into the parallel out shift register. This type of the shift register also act as a temporary storage device or as a time delay device similar to the CISO configuration as discussed earlier above. The data is presented in a parallel format to the parallel input pins representing PA to PD and then transferred together directly to their respective output pins representing QA to QD by the same clock pulse simultaneously, then one clock pulse loaded and unloaded the register. This arrangement for the parallel loading and the unloading is shown below. And we can understand this type of shift register to take an example of a 4-bit parallel into parallel out shift register. This is the block diagram of the parallel into parallel out shift register. Here we are using the 4 type of D flip-flop representing as a flip-flop A, flip-flop B and flip-flop C. And it is clear from this diagram all input representing PD, PC, PB, PA apply on all D type flip-flop simultaneously and all clock pulses are connected in a parallel manner. That means when we apply the clock pulse simultaneously at all D type of flip-flop, we obtain the all output across D type of flip-flop representing as a QD, QC, QB and QA in simultaneously. That's why the name of this kind of shift register is parallel in and parallel out shift register. Now we discuss about the universal shift register. As it is clear from the name it is a universal. That means this kind of the shift register can be used in any way, depend on the application what we have to transfer the data, either in the left shifting or right shifting, or in a serial manner or parallel manner, and have to collect in the serial manner or parallel manner. The universal shift register can perform any combination of the parallel and serial input to the output operation, but require condition input to specify desired function and to preload and then reset the device. A common used universal shift register is the TTL74LS194. This is the IC, and the truth table of this kind of the universal shift register is clear from the truth table, and S1 and S0 indicating the select line, and 00 0 1 1 0 are the input of this end, and we obtain this kind of in the output in this type of the shift register. Hold condition, shift to the right, shift to the left, parallel to the mode. That means the combination of these kind of the lines indicating in which case we have to shifting the right data, we have to shifting the left data and parallel manner, or maintain the same data. The application of the shift register, since as we earlier study, flip-flop can be used as a designing of register and the counter. In a same manner, the shift register can be used for making of the count various kind of the counter. The two most counter are useful as a one is them ring counter, and the second one is the Johnson counter. As we discussed the operation of the serial in parallel out shift register, it accepts the data from outside in the serial form, and it requires n clock pulse in order to shift n bit data. N bit ring counter, similarly, n bit ring counter perform the similar operation, but the only difference is that the output of the rightmost D flip flop is given as the input of the leftmost D type of flip flop instead of applying data from outside. Therefore, ring counter produces a sequence of the state, and it repeats the for every n clock cycle. And we can understand this concept by this block diagram of a 3-bit ring counter. It is clear from this ring counter, we are using the 3 number of the flip D type of flip flop, and all clock pulses are connected in parallel manner, and the output of the every flip flop is connected to the next to the input of next flip flop, and we can collect the data in a simultaneously. That is known as the parallel manner, and the output of the rightmost flip flop is connected to the input of the leftmost input of the D flip flop. And this indicating the truth table of this 3-bit ring counter. It is clear when we do not apply any kind of the clock pulse, then that output become 001, and when we apply the first clock pulse, the output become the 100, and when we apply the second clock pulse, the output become the 010, and after applying the third clock pulse, the output become the 001, and after applying any kind of the clock pulse after this step, the whole process repeated again and again. The following operation can The following operation can take place for every positive edge of the clock signal. Serial input of the first D flip flop gauge the previous output of the third flip flop. So the present output of the first D flip flop is equal to the previous output of the third flip flop. And the second one is the previous output of the first and the second D flip flop are right shifted Y 1 bit. That means the present output of the second and third D flip flop are equal to the previous output of first and second D flip flop.